wasn't so very long ago that manufacturers without a hatchback in their design range were wringing their hands in despair as rival manufacturers were going up and up the sales charts with their hatchbacks. But now we've seen the emergence of a new phenomena. It's the booted version of an already established hatchback design. Now, one of the first companies to do this was Vauxhall. They put a boot on the back of their Chevette model. They were followed by Volkswagen. They put boots on the back of the Golf and the Polo, and they called them the Jetta and the Derby. And then at Turin a couple of weeks ago, Lancia announced a booted version of the Beta. They called it the Trevi. And today we've got Talbot's new offering, the Solara. Not that the Solara is simply an Alpine with a boot on the back, even though one must say it's a pretty impressive boot, it's 10 cubic feet. No, the car is really a new range, and it's aimed straight at one of Britain's best-selling models, the Ford Cortina. The new Solara comes in 7 versions with 2 engine sizes and 4 levels of trim and equipment, and they're all identified by the usual meaningless and totally confusing lists of initials. In this case, LS, GL, GLS, and the top of the range SX. Prices vary from just over £4,000 to very nearly £6,400 for this top model. We in Britain are going to have to wait till the summer for 2 new transmissions for the Solara, the 5-speed gearbox and the automatic transmission. First, let's see how it goes. Alpine steering was always pretty heavy, so you wouldn't expect too many changes. Power steering is a very worthwhile extra, and a sunroof's also optional. Very comfortable seats, though personally I'd like a bit more length in the seat base here. It's quite quiet inside, much quieter than an Alpine. I suspect that's because they've got a boot on the back which disguises the rear suspension noise that you normally hear transmitted through in the hatchback Alpine. Now, I drive an Alpine myself, and I'm glad to see that the cornering standards haven't been sacrificed in this new car. You can really throw it around. Although this car suffered from very harsh and noisy brakes. Top gear on the 5-speed version is a proper overdrive ratio. Fourth gear is common to both the 4 and 5-speed gearboxes. Now, as you can see, we're travelling at a steady 120 kph, that's around 70 miles an hour, and the engine's only turning over at 3,200 revs. That's a nice cruising gear, and the car really would go on all day at this sort of speed.
Talbot's official fuel figures show that this 5-speed car does 34.4 mpg at a steady 75 miles an hour. I'm afraid the automatic's down to only 27.7 mpg at the same speed.
This top model has very full specifications. Power windows, stereo radio cassette, central door locking, headlamp wash wipe system, head restraints, and a lot of attention to the standard of interior trim with velour seat coverings and thick carpets thrown in. And in all models, there's a lot of legroom in the back, even with the front seats quite a long way back. Very full set of instruments for the driver, and of course the Talbot onboard computer here, which gives you your elapsed time, the time of the journey, the time of the day, number of kilometres you've covered, the average speed you've been going, and the amount of fuel you've been consuming. Now, an unusual feature for a British car nowadays is a cruise control button here. You can see I press it in and the car maintains the speed it was going at without my foot on the throttle. It's very comfortable, very easy to cruise on a motorway with it once you've got used to driving it. Now, in 1979, Ford sold 200,000 Cortinas, while Talbot sold only 30,000 Alpines. They're going to have to fight very hard to compete in this sector of the market, especially in the fleet sector, where every other importer and manufacturer in the country is hoping for sales. It's a fiercely competitive market, and the Solara is going to have to fight very hard for its share of it.